29, the Rama points out that that the day after Pesach is considered to be the Isuro Shel Chag, the Isur Chag, which is today.
Okay.
Right? It says, Nohagin Nalbot Ksat Ba'achila U'Shtiyah B'Yom Achar HaChag, is a custom, widespread custom, to have a little bit more food, more drinking, a little bit alcohol on the day after HaChag, because it's Isuro Shel Chag. It's the last day, like, you know, it's the wrapping up. We're wrapping up the holiday, so might as well make a faster celebration. But please do not forget, we are accustomed not to have any music playing at all until Lamed Daled Ba'Omer. So we have to wait till the 34th day with all that. So please do remember that we do not go ahead and play music on this day. We just simply have a good suuda. In a way, it's also tell the kids. The reason why we're having a little bit extra is for one reason only, because it's Yisro Chag. It's a day after the holiday. So please do remember that. Another, get to Halachot of Sfirat HaOmer, Siman Taf Peitet, we have to get to understand the Halachot of counting the Sfirat HaOmer. We know the Torah says that where every single Jew is obligated, men are obligated to count Sfirat HaOmer, to count the 7 weeks, right? We count days and we count weeks. As the Gemara says, Mitzvah Limimni Yomei, Mitzvah Limimni Shavui, right? The Mitzvah is to count days, the Mitzvah is to count weeks. So please do remember that it's two separate mitzvot, in the way the Rambam says they are counted as two separate ones, but really considered one mitzvah. It's like two mitzvot that are really one. Okay? So you look in the Rambam, he speaks about it. Okay. Anyhow, let us to understand the concept. There is a concept to count Svirata over the days. Reason why we are counting is, as we all know, that HaKadosh Baruch Hu said in the Torah, Chok, an obligatory mitzvah, Hashem says that B'machmat HaPesach, the next day after Pesach, you have to start counting Svirat HaOmer. And you count 49 days, and on the 50th day is going to be Shavuot. As we all know, there's no set day for Shavuot in Torah. It doesn't say anywhere, Vav Siman, Zayin Siman, Hey Siman, does not say when Shavuot is. The only way we know when Shavuot is when we count 7 weeks after Mimachot HaShabbat, after the day of the first day of Yom Tov, of Pesach. That's how we know when Shavuot is. So we count 49 days to get to the 50th day. 50th day is the Kabbalat HaTorah. Okay. The mitzvah is to count the days. The way we count days is as follows. We know that we count, today Mincha is going to be at 7:40 for all those who want to get together. You should try to arrange something during the week too, by the way. If you have people in the area anyways, at 7:40 you can have the minyan. You should have some mincha arvit together. And there's also, just want to let everybody know, some people do learn here at night too. You could join them also. Please come to learn. It's very important. If you have other shiur, if you want to come to learn, always run to go to the Bet Midrash. Let me just get a sidetrack a little. My rabbi advised me to do this. He says, the best thing you'll ever do in chinuch iladim is not when you're actually going to sit down and learn with your child. Yeah, the best thing you'll ever do with your child is when you yourself run away to go to Beit Midrash. Every single night, you tell yourself, I don't care how long it is, even if it's a half hour, make it chashuv, make it important, that every single day, you go to Beit Midrash. The kids ask, where's Papa? The mother says to the father, to the kids, father, not run off, the father went to Beit Midrash to learn. That is, the child, it rubs in. Rabbi Avraham Kalmanovich said this to his Talmidim. He says, it's not so much, it's very important to learn with your kids. But more important is for our father to disappear every single day to Beit Midrash, no matter what. Half hour, an hour, an hour and a half, it instills in the kids that what? There's a set time, we go to Beit Midrash to learn. In the house, you can learn, but how much can you accomplish? So many kirdot, so many tirchot, so many things that bother you around. When you walk away from everything, you have a clear mind, you're able to concentrate, you have an easy way of learning, no one is disturbing you, and you go and you learn Torah. It's very important. Rabbeinu Yonah says the obligation for every single woman, when the husband comes home, don't waste his time, don't talk to him too much. You should tell him straightforward, huh? Han, do me a favor, the Beit Midrash is down the block, please go to learn. I want a ticket for Olam Haba just like you do. So please do, every single woman should go ahead and work on herself and, you know, concentrate on the idea that what? That the husband should go to learn Torah. Don't waste husband's time too much. Because after all, her Olam Haba depends on him. Him sitting and learning. Not wasting away his evenings and schmoozing away. It's enough that he wants to work for you, to support you, to do for you. Sure, you should spend time with the wife, of course, not saying not to. Quality time, very important, but most important is that, you know, send the husband away to go learn Torah. This is the best thing you'll ever do for yourself. Okay, so we start counting Sefirat HaOmer. It says like this, it says that the time to count Sefirat HaOmer is at the beginning of the night. It's a big machloket aposkim, exactly when is exactly pinpoint. Like muhudar muhudar, that you should wait for Tzedek HaKochavim, for the three stars to come out in order to count Sefirat HaOmer. You have to have the stars come out to count Sefirat. There is a machloket aposkim, the Shulchan Aruch points out the interesting thing. He says that if people count Sefirat HaOmer a little bit before Tzedek HaKochavim, they do go out of their obligation. Now what it's talking about is a big machloket aposkim. All the Achronim spilled so much ink on it, and there's a lot to delve into the concept. We're going to get to that soon. So the mitzvah is to count at the beginning of every single night, because that is the beginning of the day. And when the day is clear that this is the beginning of the day, that's when you go ahead and you count Sefirat HaOmer for yourself. It says over here that the person is supposed to count Sefirat HaOmer while he is standing. If a person is not able to stand, he could do it in any other position as well. But if he's able to stand, he should stand. And he should first make a bracha. And the bracha he recites is Asher Kedushanu, Baruch Atah Hashem, Elokeinu Melech Haolam, Asher Kedushanu B'mitzvotav, V'tzivanu Al Sefirat HaOmer, right, on the counting of the Omer. And he says, afterwards he starts counting the days, and after he counts the days, he counts 2 weeks. First we count always the days, and then we count the weeks. Now, if Shulchan Aruch goes ahead and spills a little more ink than usual, he goes ahead and he explains. On the first day, you go ahead and say, Hayom Yom Echad, it doesn't say La Omer. We have Sfaradim Noek to say La Omer. Ashkenazim say Be Omer. Okay. Be Omer. Now, until we get to 7 days. Once we get to 7 days, we say today is 7 days. Hayom Shiv'a Yamim La Omer. Sheem Shavua Echad. They are 1 week. Okay? That's how we count. Then he says on the 8th day, you go ahead and you say Hayom Shmona Yamim La Omer. Sheem Shavua Echad V'yom Echad. They're 1 week and 1 day. Until he gets to all the way till 2:14, and then he says, "Hayom Abasa Yamim." Today is 14 days. Shem Shnei Shavuot. There are 2 weeks. This is the way you go ahead and you count until you get to 49 days. Okay, that is the way to go ahead and do. Now,
mitzvah is rabbinic in our generation.
The mitzvah. Okay, so we're going to talk about that soon. Also, let's also point out that we know that normally Sefirat HaOmer and mitzvah deolaita. According to some Lishonim, it's the Olayit, even Bezman HaZeh, but everybody agrees today, after Chuban Bet HaMikdash, we don't, due to the circumstances that we are found in, we all have, according to all the poskim, it's Rabbanan, it's rabbinical. Therefore, when you say in the Shem Yichud, people, those that say the Shem Yichud, they should say over there, Mitzvah Tzvidat HaOm, not Mitzvah Taseh. Don't say Mitzvah Taseh, because it's not really Mitzvah Taseh. We don't want you to go ahead and, you know, lose track. It is Drabanan rabbinical according to the Kuli Alma, and therefore there's many leniences come to this fact that you go ahead, if you count it a little bit earlier, you do go out of your obligation. We'll talk about soon how early. Now, the reason why we say you're supposed to have Sefirat HaOmer standing, because over there we learn from the, it says, Ma'achir Chermesh Bakama. It says, Bakama is Chazal Se'a Tigre Bakama Ela Bekoma. Right, when you, Koma means standing. You're going to be upright when you make the Bracha. From here we learn that all Asher Kedushanus have to really be standing. Besides one that we say that tefillin, right, has to be sitting down. As big Kabbalah, the Shulchan Aruch does bring that down. The Shulchan that the bracha of tefillin should be sitting down. I always have wondered if the Birkot HaTorah, the bracha of Torah, does it have to be standing or not? I didn't really see anybody speaking about it. Please, if someone does see something about it, if you're supposed to make Birkat Asher Kedushanu by Birkat HaTorah standing, please do let me know.
Why this says you can stand or sit?
You could stand or sit. I do remember seeing it, but the question is the Ma'akev, can you sit? Is the question, because Asher Kedushanu has a deen that you have to be standing. Okay, let's go further. Another thing is...
Al Achilat Matzah, we're sitting, no?
Al Achilat Matzah, we're sitting because...
Asher Kedushanu.
That's a good one. I don't know. That's also, maybe it has to do with Achilah, because Achilah is done while you're reclining. You're not supposed to be standing. Make a motzi first. You're supposed to be sitting. Okay, don't know. Another one is... let us proceed further. It says like this. It says, let me skip to Halacha Gimal, and then we're going to go to Halacha Bet to explain exactly what's flying. It says the following. It says, those people who pray with the shul, with the minyan, where they're still praying Mincha and Alvit early on, right? We know that you're supposed to pray Alvit always when three stars come up, when they said the Kohavim. You're not really supposed to pray Arvit early on. Many Kihilot Sfarad and some Kihilot Ashkenaz as well, depends on the situation in the area where there's no minyan, very hard to gather a minyan. Sometimes it's convenience, and sometimes I don't know what you want to call it. Just, you know, let's get over with it, right? Fast. Religion, Yiddishkeit, doesn't have to be done with a lot of pressure. Go, you know, easy up a little, smile. It's good to, you know, it's good to be a Jew. It's not always like, you know, they have to be always like, you know, hiding from a stick every time. Okay. Hakadosh Baruch Hu is not holding a stick to hit us. But let's go further. It says like this. So when you do pray and you do go out of your obligation, the question is, what about Sfirat Talmud? What do we do? Okay, so if it's very early on and you're praying Plaga Mincha, please don't count Sfirat HaOmer at that time. So don't do that. That's a big no-no. According to most Poskim, when it says here that it says that people that pray early on, that they could count Sfirat HaOmer, right? Could do, the shul counts Sfirat HaOmer, and they make a bracha, they still advise every individual by himself not to make a bracha. Should not count Sfirat HaOmer. If he does count Sfirat HaOmer at that time, he should make a tznai, he should make a condition. What time are we talking about? We're talking about Ben HaShemashot time. Because Ben HaShemashot is Safek Yom, Safek Laila. Now, the way Ben HaShemashot works is, you should know, it's a three-way Safek. Simcha knows this because we got Shabbat just now, right? It's a three-way Safek. Safek, it's daytime. Safek, it's nighttime. Safek, it's day and night. Go figure out which one it is. So we don't know clearly what exactly Ben HaShemashot is. We have a three-way Safek how to deal with it. Now, because it's we know that Sfirat HaOmer today is rabbinical. Because it's rabbinical, you can be lenient. You can go ahead and not say, you're only allowed to count when three stars come out. No, you can count a bit earlier on as well. So we tell the person that if you do count early on, please do yourself a favor. If the community counts, you should count without a bracha and have in mind the following. I am counting. In case I remember to count later, I don't want this counting to be a proper counting. Okay? You do with a condition. If I will remember to count later with a bracha, I don't want to be yotzeh now. But for sure now, you should not make a bracha. Okay? So the way you do it, when they pray early on, and they count Sfirat HaOmer with a bracha, which they have, with the day, go ahead, and by Ben HaShemashot time, late Ben HaShemashot, not early Ben HaShemashot. In America especially, you got to go to later. Not like the, like, you know, the a lot of people under the assumption, when it says in Yakut Yosef 13 and a half minutes, they assume that this is how it's worldwide. It's not true. It's not true at all. Because we are more up north, it's more time. Okay? It's much more than 25, 30 minutes more. Contra Moshe, you have 40, 45 minutes, Ben HaShemashot. So, it's not so simple. Let's go further. Okay? So we have, so when they do count Sfirat HaOmer, they count because this is the way that's because they want to count now. They're not going to do it later. But you yourself, when you're going to count, right? So say, I'm going to count now, but it should not be a mitzvah, only if I forget to count later. And then, later on, when you get home, and you have to repeat Kriyat Shema all over again, because you prayed Arvit early, so you could pray, you have to say Shema Yisrael first, and then you should count Sfirat HaOmer with the Bracha, in order to catch on to the count of the mitzvot. Okay, it's very appropriate for many communities that in the mornings, the Chazan goes ahead and says loudly what days of Sfirat HaOmer it is, and this is how it also reminds people, those people forget to count, that they count in the actual daytime in order to not make that mistake. That's it. Tomorrow we're going to go ahead and talk about Halakha Bet, which talks about if it's a cloudy day, what happened if it was dark enough outside, people made a mistake, and also what to do when a person, his friend, goes over to him and asks him, what day of Sfirat HaOmer is it today? So we'll talk about those type of instances tomorrow.